Dear students, welcome to Dynamics of Machine Lab. Today we are going to perform one more experiment that is called holding of shaft or critical speed study of critical speed of shaft or holding of shaft or whipping speed of shaft. So this is the our experimental setup. This is controller where we can put this speed of the motor. This is on button, this is off button, and these are the some button switch where we can do different controls. So this is the actual experimental setup. This is motor, and this is called the proximity sensor where we can sense the speed of the shaft or the motor. So this experimental setup is covered with this transparent perspex sheet, and this side you have seen one bearing attachment. And this is nylon bushing, this one nylon bushing, this is motor that coupling where we can, bearing is inside where we can fix the shaft. So this side also this motor, and this while doing the test, this will be, this cover we will put in, and for fixing the shaft, removing the shaft, this cover you need to take out. We will take out and we will put it in some safe location. So we are having different shafts: 6 mm, 3 mm, and 7 mm diameter shaft. So this shaft will be used for studying the critical speed or holding speed of this setup, an experimental setup. It is having some weights also. First we will demonstrate you load, unloaded shaft, and next we are having some specific loads. This 300 gram, one hole is here, and this we will insert into, through this hole we will insert inside the mid center of the shaft, and this is hole for eccentric loading. This load will use 300 gram, and these are two other loads masses. So this one also 300 gram, this is also 300 gram. These two was single mass, single load or double load we will put, and we will see the holding of how holding effects in the shaft. So we are having 3 mm, 6 mm, and 7 mm diameter shaft, and length of the shafts are 900 mm and 750 mm. So in 3 mm and 6 mm shaft, we cannot put load. Means that those shaft in unloaded condition, we will fix it and we will give speed. Then we will able to see the critical speed of shaft or wheeling speed of the shaft. And next 7 mm diameter shaft where we can add this masses, this loads, that is, that will be loaded shaft. Loaded condition we will do once, and then we will put this different loads: single load, double load, and eccentric load. And this is another load, this is 400 gram. So this way we will perform this experiment. So already 3 mm diameter shaft and 750 mm length already fitted. So now we will give speed and we will see the whirling phenomenon. So before that, what is whirling, what is critical speed, we should know.
So let us first know what is whirling. So basically, we have to know what is resonance. So resonance is the state in which the external frequency that matches the natural frequency of the system. So at that state, that becomes the state of resonance, and that state, it leads to very huge vibrations which may further cause catastrophic damage to the equipment or the setup, and that has to be avoided in most of the cases. But in certain cases, that is helpful also, for example in case of turbines. So in this case we will study how to obtain, how to observe the critical speed of whirling speed. So we have a system of whirling speed setup where we would mount one shaft under fixed conditions, and we'll see how the parameters like length, diameter, they affect the whirling speed, critical speed of the whirling, and also certain if we put some additional masses on the shaft, that also affects the values for critical speed of whirling. So we'll study all these parameters. While learning this experiment, we need to know what is first mode frequency, what is second mode whirl, and what is first mode whirl, and some higher order whirls. So this is the first mode whirl, where it reaches the first natural frequency. So in this condition, you will see that a single bow shaped shape comes. So that is your first mode whirl. You will get 2 points here, and at the center you will get the highest amplitude. In case of second mode whirl, you will notice two whirls are produced and intersecting each other, and point of intersection, that is not known as node. So one node is formed in case of second mode whirl, and so on. In case of third mode whirl, you will notice two nodes are produced and three whirls are produced. We have mounted one shaft under fixed conditions of diameter 3 mm, and didn't tie the central cord in order to achieve the first whirl mode. So we'll observe the values of shaft speed for getting the first mode whirl. So we'll start the motor. So we'll turn the regulator. Yeah, so now the shaft is whirling. So at a certain speed, you will notice that the shaft speed reaches the first natural frequency, that is the state of resonance, where it will vibrate, transversely vibrate hugely.
Coupling, there is a bearing, 100 bearing, that one Allen screw is there, so we are putting this Allen screw here. Then through this nylon bush we will put it, and we fix it and insert it this side. After that, again we will this nylon bushing also we will shift it this that side. After that we will insert it inside the slot. Once we insert it inside the slot, we have to tighten it firmly. We have to tighten it, otherwise while giving speed shaft may come out or shaft may get bent. So we will tight it, this one tighten properly. After the tightening we will put it for some time so that we can fix this side. First we are having washers. Washers we are having, that washers we will put this side, this nut we will put. You can show this side, you can show this side clearly, you can show the nut. This is the nut, and with this nut we will tighten it firmly by using the spanner. This we will put it, then we will tight it so that while giving rotation speed it will not come out. We will tight it. After tightening it is tightened. Now what we will do, we will fix this one, this Allen screws are there, but using Allen key we will fix it. This we will fix it. After that, for first mode of hole, we will place it. This is for safety, actually, for safety purpose. Otherwise, if we will not put it, then what will happen? It will while critical speed or holding speed, shaft may touch the this frame. Fixed it. Now this is over. First we will study the, we will see the first mode of hold. Then next mode, what we will do, we will tie this cord in the center of this shaft by measuring, using the measuring tape we will measure it like this. Then we will put this cord exactly in the center. Then we will able to see the second mode of hold. So first let's see first mode of holding. For that again you need to put this cover. Now we will switch on it. So I am increasing the speed. So now this one, you have seen this holding. So this is the first mode of holding. Practically we are getting it 930 RPM, revolution per minute. Theoretically you need to calculate, you know the shaft geometry, shaft diameter, length, and fixed condition, fixed in condition. So that way you can calculate the holding speed or critical speed. So this is the first mode of hold. First simple bow shaft. Then we will stop here, we will reduce. Once we get the first mode of holding bow shaft, we will get the speed. Then we need to immediately reduce the speed, because if you continuously run this machine, this then shaft may permanently get damaged. So we will reduce the speed once we get the value. Now we will stop it. Now this one we will take out, this cover we will take out, we will place it here. Now we will tie this. Thread. hot air. Exactly we need to put it center. So from this point to this point we will measure it is 900. Now we will place it in the center, means 450. 450 we will lose it. We will lose it and bring it exactly in the center. 400. This is 50. So here we will put it. Some more we will shift it. This way we will put it. We will tie it like this. Tie it like this. This way we will put it. Now this one fixed. We will tie it. And this nylon bushing we will shift it to this side. This one, this that. This side we will see it. Otherwise, if we put it here, then it will prevent the formation of bow shape. Formation of typical speed. Put it like this. Everything are tightened. Now we will place this one. Now we will study the cedar second mode of holding. So we will switch it on, then we will give the rotation speed. We will go on increasing speed gradually. We will go on increasing the speed. Second mode of hold, we are seeing double bow shape. This is the center point, is the node. So in second mode of hold, we will able to see first node of hold, first node, and like that way it is cumulative. And if you go for third mode of holding, then we will get two nodes. That way it will be cumulative and increasing. So once you get the holding speed, the critical speed, we need to decrease the speed after noting down these values. Holding speed, the critical speed values. So now we reduce the speed. We will stop. So this is the experiment. Stop. So same way we will perform the experiment on this 6 mm diameter shaft. In this shaft we will able to see only first mode of whirl. So second mode of whirling not possible in this shaft as machine's motor capacity is less. So if we have higher capacity motor, if we put, then we can able to see second mode of whirl in this shaft. In this experimental setup, only 3 mm diameter and 900 mm shaft only we will able to see the second mode of hold. So this way we can perform the experiment. Now we will going to show you using masses. So this is 7 mm diameter shaft, length is 900 mm. So in this shaft we will put some masses, known masses. So 300 gram, this one mass. So this is having eccentricity, one hole is here, and these are three different masses. This is 300 gram, this is also 300 gram, this is 400 gram. So this mass we will use. So how to fix? I will first now fix the 7 mm diameter shaft. And we will put mass here. So I have already fixed 7 mm diameter shaft, and length is shaft length is 900 mm, and this 400 gram mass I kept it exactly in the center of this shaft, means 450 mm distance. Now we will run this experiment. We will see in loading condition, loaded condition, how much the critical speed or holding speed. Once we do loaded condition, again we will take out the load from the shaft and we will again run the machine. Then we will see the holding of speed or critical speed. Then we will get the difference. If we add mass, what will be the sense, what will be the effect of holding of speed or critical speed? So now let's start. I'll press this one, switch on, then I will give some, gradually give some speed. So I am giving speed. Now you see steps is rotating with the mass. Now it is vibrating. So you have seen this is the holding on critical speed of this step. So once we get the speed around 990, so this is the holding on critical speed. Lots of vibration, lots of noises are coming. So with this way we will keep on running, then shaft may permanently get damaged and bearing also get damaged, and it will, all setup will vibrate. Already lots of vibrations are there. So already we have got this value 990, 92, in between that. So this is the holding is the critical speed. So now we will decrease the speed. Once we get the critical speed or holding speed, we will decrease the speed and we finally will. Gradually decreasing the speed, so we will now stop. We have got this value, critical speed or holding speed value of this shaft with loaded condition. That is, this is the load, and now we will do next experiment in unloaded condition without any load, just plain shaft we will rotate. Then we will see the holding or critical speed of that plain shaft. And we will come to know the difference between loaded shaft and unloaded shaft critical speed or holding speed. Now we are going to demonstrate first mode of hold on this 7 mm diameter shaft, length is 900 mm, without any load. This is unloaded shaft. Already loaded shaft already we have did. Now we will go for unloaded shaft. Already I fixed the shaft in this setup. Now we will start. So for starting, this is the button, switch it on, then gradually we will increase the speed through this potentiometer. Now you can see this is the revolution speed RPM. So now shaft is rotating. After, if you go on increasing the speed, then when it reaches RPM. We got practical value, we got theoretical value. You need to calculate using formula, and we will provide you experimental handout or manuals, and they are all details, theory and formulas are there. So this is the holding of speed experiment, holding of speed or critical speed experiment we have performed. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you.